Welcome to this video on autocorrelation. After completing this video, you will be able to explain the intuition and calculation behind autocorrelation and interpretation of the autocorrelation plot. Suppose you want to forecast the wheat futures prices. You look at various factors that affect the price of wheat, such as climate and oil prices. But the most important determinant is its lagged prices. For example, if the price of wheat increases for the last 12 months, you would expect the wheat price to increase this month. To understand this intuitively, say, you have the price of wheat futures at the end of May, June and July. May's wheat price has some impact on June's wheat price. And June's wheat price has some impact on July's wheat price. So, the price of wheat in May has some impact on the price of wheat in July, through June. This impact is known as the indirect effect. But it is also possible to have some direct relationship between the price of wheat in May and July. Why does this happen? This can be due to fundamental reasons, such as change in agricultural commodity pricing policy at a fixed time interval, say every 2 months. Let's take an example. The wheat futures prices at the end of month from May to July are shown on screen. From May to June it increased by 10%. Then, from June to July it increased by 10% plus $1, which is 10% from June and $1 from May. Similarly, from July to August, it increased by 10%. Then, from August to September, it increased by 10% plus $1, which is 10% from August, and $1 from July. So, from May to July and from July to September, there is a direct relationship of $1 increase in price. This is a simplified example and easy to identify the pattern or relationship between prices. In real scenarios, these relationships are complicated. How can you find the relationship of, say, prices in current month with prices 2 months prior to it? You can find the correlation between prices in a month and the prices 2 months back. To find correlation, we have taken the data for the past 10 years. Stored the time series in Y and 2 month lag time series in X. The correlation comes out to 0.93. This is also called autocorrelation, or serial correlation, as you are finding correlation of a time series with its lagged values. Similarly, you can find autocorrelation with 1 month lagged values, 3 months lagged values and so on, by plotting the graph. The autocorrelation with 2 months lagged value is 0.93. The plot is called the autocorrelation plot. The y-axis has autocorrelation value, which ranges between minus 1 and plus 1, and x-axis is the lagged terms. From this plot, can you tell me autocorrelation with 5 months lagged values? Yes, it is approximately 0.85, which you can find by looking at the height of this vertical line. You might be wondering what this blue shaded region is. You can think it as anything inside the shadow or band is statistically insignificant. In other words, the autocorrelation values outside the blue region is not a fluke. Till the 10th lags, it is outside the blue region. So, up to past 10 months values have direct and indirect impact on the current prices. You can use this information to predict next month's wheat price. The prediction will be covered in the upcoming sections. Even though the wheat prices are positively correlated, the wheat prices monthly returns not necessarily are autocorrelated. As you can see, in the autocorrelation plot of monthly returns for the past 20 months, they are not statistically significant. In other words, monthly returns of wheat futures are random and they are independent of each other. That's all for this video.